3 weeks from today, it's Florida's turn with the presidential preference primary election, including a statewide referendum on property taxes. WESH 2 political reporter Greg Fox tells us what voters need to know and why some voting will start next week.
Candidates clamoring for attention.
John Edwards in 08.
Canvassing the streets of New Hampshire for support. It's a roadshow that's coming to Florida.
Yes, 119 West Katy.
At the Orange County Elections Office, the phone bank has been busy with calls from people asking, will my vote count on January 29th? Referring to the national political party's decisions to disqualify all of the state's Democratic delegates and half of the Republican delegates to punish Florida for moving up its primary date. But election supervisors are urging people to remember there are local races and a proposed amendment to cut property taxes on the ballot.
To make sure voters have the right information, election supervisors are mailing out sample ballots like this. They should be arriving in your mailbox this week. In Orange County, for example, there are 50 changes, so make sure that you read it. And on the back, listings of early voting locations.
And we encourage them to pre-mark their ballots and particularly read the property tax amendment before they get to the polls.
Most voters we talked with say despite lingering doubts about the importance of the presidential preference primary in Florida, they will vote.
I think it's our responsibility, and I don't buy that a single vote doesn't count. I don't buy it at all.
There's going to be no delegates for you. You're going to vote anyway?
Yeah. Why not?
How come?
Because it's my right. Everybody should vote.
And just as you did in the 2006 election, you don't have to bring your voter registration card to the precincts. You can bring a photo ID and a document with your signature, or in my case, you just bring a driver's license. That's all you'll need when you go to the polls. And again, early voting begins on Monday. Wendy?